started. At first, I'm going to invite Ronald Onion to come up, please. Ronald.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound loud as the rolling sea. Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the faith that the present has brought us. Facing the rising sun of our new day begun, let us march on till victory is won.
Thank you, everybody. Power to the people! So what I like to do is I like to recognize some folks that are in the audience. This first person I'm going to have come up and stand next to me is going to be Camille High. Camille High is with Blacks and Bayonne. If you folks don't know her, Camille High had the courage to start this Juneteenth celebration with the flag raising. Actually, Camille, this is your third year.
Yes.
Well, you know, Camille, I need you to come up here. We're gonna let you come up in a second. But in the meantime, there's other folks in this audience that I think you really need to meet, because I'm telling you, they have done a fantastic job in terms of bringing people of color to the administration, bringing people of color to our school system. They definitely have to come up. You folks have to greet them. I need to bring up Mayor Davis and Superintendent John Neese. They have been doing a fantastic job. Everybody needs to give them a round of applause. Please come on up, Mayor. Mayor Davis, John Neese, please. And again, as I have mentioned, folks, again, they've been very instrumental in terms of helping folks of color. The school system has recruited over, in the past 3 years, your superintendent said a lot, and believe me, I'm going to just tell you something. I'm there, I'm also working as one of the defendants, and I will be a witness to that. He's been doing a fantastic job in terms of making sure that people of color and that everybody gets a chance to really express themselves at the school with working within the Department of Education. Next, I'm going to let the mayor talk about it. You can see the mayor's ticket. We're all happy that he won again. As you can see, the mayor has a monopoly in terms of running Bayonne, being in charge of Bayonne. So I'm going to give the mic over to the mayor.
I just want to welcome everyone here to the first annual Juneteenth celebration, which will continue year on, year out. And this is about bringing everyone together. And that's what the city of Bayonne is. And that's what it was when I was a child and when I grew up here. We didn't look at each other any different. Because if you look around the whole park, every single one of us is different in different ways. And all it takes is for us to teach our children that this is the way you live your life. You accept and respect everyone. And that's what it all comes down to. It's very simple. It's a simple concept. It's common sense. And if we do that and teach our children, as those generations come up and teach their children, we make a better community and a better country. So thank you all for being here today.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Someone told me once, you will get everything in life you want if you help enough other people get what they want. And it's about building a community and being part of our community. And I'm just honored and I'm very honored to be here and continue to celebrate this holiday. So thank you, Mayor, Mr. Byrd, everyone, thank you.
Next, I'm going to give the mic to someone who's not a stranger. So if you've been in Bayonne for the last 3 years, okay, I'm sorry, if you've been in Bayonne for a while now, you definitely, if you don't know her face, you definitely know her name. So I'm going to have her self introduce herself again. The reason why I'm inviting this young lady up is because, again, she took the courage to get this thing started in terms of the Juneteenth celebration here in Bayonne. With the flag raising, and also with the cooperation of the administration, we've been she has been successful in having us celebrate Juneteenth and bringing the meeting here to Bayonne.
Happy Juneteenth, everybody, powerful people. I'm really, really, really excited and happy to have everyone out here. This has been the blackest weekend. I've lived in Bayonne for 32 years, and for the first time, I am seeing my people, and I'm very excited. We're super excited that the NAACP has decided to do this event this weekend. Again, it is up to us to create change. We want change to happen. We have to speak up. We have to show up. And it will only happen if we continue to use our voices. That's all I have to say. Thank you to everyone that is here, those that will come. Happy Juneteenth. Power to the people.
Thank you. Next person I'm going to bring to the stage. Now we're going to go right into our entertainment, and I'd like to invite. Oh, I'm sorry, Dave. Do they know you? They don't know you. Bayonne. Yes, yes. I'd like to thank all of the dignitaries that came up, and I am back in Bayonne, and I'm black in Bayonne. All right. It's good to be black. I mean back. And I have to thank the superintendent for my short stint on the Board of Education. It was short, but it was good. I have to tell you, this guy loves Bayonne, and he loves your children. Unfortunately, I moved out of town, so they did one of these. They gave me the boot. And that's okay, because I still got a picture with them, so I'm good to go. They got a lot of programs geared towards our children, and that's what's important, because they're the ones that we're here for. Come on, parents now, you know. I see parents in the back that helped raise us. Ms. Edwards, come on now. 582, what? I was 10 years old, and you would keep an eye on me. See, that's what they did when we were young. The parents kept an eye on kids. You do that now, you're going to find some trouble. Because parents are supporting their kids and not the elder adults that are taking care of them. And we need to remember that it takes a village. So I'm going to get my music going. Thank you for letting me talk. Because if I don't put this microphone down, Gary, I'll stay up here for 15 minutes. 46th Street, yes. I love Bayonne, and I came here today. I have Ambrosia. She's on her way. She got stuck behind a train in 280, but that's another story. But I'm going to play a couple instrumentals, and we're going to have some fun. You got a whole day planned of a whole bunch of good stuff. Thank you.
Skin is not Thank you. for you guys. How about that? Now on the stage, we're gonna do on the floor over there. Okay? Let's go, give it up.